गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स, इन क्लास प्रैक्टिकल आई हैव डिस्कस टू प्रिपेयर द न्यूट्रिएंट्स प्लांट स्टैब एंड सब कल्चरिंग ऑफ डिफरेंट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म। टुडे वी विल सी द नेक्स्ट प्रैक्टिकल, दैट इज ग्राम स्टेनिंग। सो इट इज एम ऑफ प्रैक्टिकल टू स्टडी द बैक्टीरियल मॉर्फोलॉजी बाई द यूज ऑफ और बाई ग्राम स्टेनिंग टेक्निक। What are the requirements for this practical? First, in that culture media or the cultures, for in cultures, the broad culture of E. coli and the Bacillus cereus and the Staphylococcus aureus. There are three cultures required for practical. First, the Escherichia coli, then Bacillus cereus and Staphylococcus aureus. Then the stains for this practical, crystal violet and safranin. Then reagent required for this practical, ethyl alcohol, that is 95% ethyl alcohol and grams iodine. Next, apparatus required for this practical, staining tray, glass slides, burner, inoculating loop and glass slide. And equipment required for this practical, that is microscope. Yes, what are the requirements for this practical? First, cultures. In that first, there are three cultures required for this practical, E. coli, then Bacillus cereus and Staphylococcus aureus. Then stains required for this practical, crystal violet and safranin. Then reagent required for this practical, ethyl alcohol, that is 95% and grams iodine. Then apparatus, staining tray, glass slides, burner, inoculating loop and glass slides. Then equipments for this practical, that is microscope. Yes, we will see the introduction about this practical. Yes, this is an important bacteriological staining procedure and it was discovered in 1884 by a scientist Christian Graham. These things I have already discussed in your theory lecture. Yes, this Graham staining is discovered in the year 1884 by the scientist Christian Graham. This Graham staining is based on the cell wall structure of the bacteria. Keep in mind, it is important, this introductory part or principle. This Graham staining is based upon what? Based upon the cell wall structure of the bacteria. When the bacteria is stained with crystal violet, when the bacteria are stained with crystal violet, the cell wall of gram-negative bacteria can be easily decolorized with organic solvents for example ethanol or the acetone. When the bacteria are stained with crystal violet, then the cells of gram-negative bacteria can be easily decolorized with organic solvents such as ethanol or the acetone. While the cell wall of gram-positive bacteria, it restricts the decolorization. Keep in mind the difference. This gram-positive bacteria, it restricts decolorization, and this gram-negative bacteria is easily decolorized with the help of organic solvent, that is ethanol or the acetone. And this gram-positive bacteria, it restricts the decolorization. Next, the ability of bacteria to either retain or the lose, sorry, the ability of bacteria to either retain or lose the stain generally reflect the fundamental difference in the cell wall and is an important taxonomic feature. Either it retain or either lose the stain. Then the gram staining is therefore used as an initial step in identification of bacteria. Yes, therefore the gram staining is used as an initial step in the identification of bacteria. Then the cell wall of some bacteria are strongly gram positive when young, but tends to become gram negative in aging culture, for example Bacillus cereus and Clostridium species, which may reflect the degenerative changes in the cell wall. And the some bacteria give a gram variable reaction. They are sometimes gram positive and sometimes it is gram negative. This could reflect the minor variation in the staining technique or the changes in the cell wall thickness. Then before starting, make sure that the all reagents as well as the all the requirements are easily accessible, because you won't have time or you don't have time to go get them during the staining procedure. It means what? During performing the practical, make sure that all requirements are ready or not. Then also make sure you are doing this near a sink, because it can get really messy. And during performing this practical, make a sterile condition. So this is all about introduction of this gram staining. Next we will see the principle. Yes, in principle it is differential staining technique, and it helps to distinguish the bacteria in two groups, that is gram positive bacteria and gram negative bacteria. And it is based upon the difference in structure of cell wall of bacteria. I am repeating the principle. It is differential staining technique. And second, this technique helps to distinguish the bacteria into two groups, that is gram positive bacteria and gram negative bacteria. And this technique is based upon the difference in structure of cell wall of bacteria. Next we will see the difference between gram positive bacteria and gram positive bacteria. This difference is also already discussed in theory lecture. I am repeating this difference. Yes, gram positive bacteria and gram negative bacteria. In gram positive bacteria, according to the gram staining, it retains the color, and it is stained to violet color. So called as gram positive. And in gram negative, according to the gram staining technique, it does not retain the color. And when it is stained, it is colorless, and so it is called as gram negative. Then second difference, after counter staining with safranin, that is safranin is used as a counter stain. After counter staining with safranin, the basic stain, it is stained with a purple color. And in case of gram negative bacteria, after counter staining with safranin, that is basic stain, it is stained with a pink color. Then next, it is characterized by presence of higher amount of peptidoglycan. Next, it contains very low amount of peptidoglycan. In case of gram negative bacteria, it contains very low amount of peptidoglycan. Then in gram positive bacteria, magnesium ribonucleate is present. In case of gram negative bacteria, the magnesium ribonucleate is absent. Then in gram positive bacteria, it contains lower amount of lipid in cell wall. In gram negative bacteria, it contains higher amount of lipid in the cell wall. Next, in gram positive bacteria, it does not get decolorized after treating with 95% alcohol. And in gram negative bacteria, it get decolorized after treating with alcohol. That is after treating with 95% of alcohol. Next, in gram positive bacteria, it retains the color of primary stain after counter staining with safranin. And in case of gram negative bacteria, it absorbs the counter stain, that is safranin, and it appears as a pink color. So this is the difference between the gram positive bacteria and the gram negative bacteria. Next we will see the stain or the different reagents that are used in gram staining technique. First primary stain, then second modern stain, next decolorizing agent, and last that is counter stain. First primary stain The crystal violet is used as a primary stain in gram staining technique. This primary stain, it stain both cellular gram positive and gram negative bacteria. Yes, this stain, it stain both the gram cellular gram positive as well as gram negative bacteria. After staining, both type of microbial cell will retain the violet color. Then second, that is mordant. Here there is use of grams iodine solution. Yes, this mordant, it form a insoluble complex with stain and fix the color of bacterial cell wall. Yes, it forms a insoluble complex with stain and it fix the color to bacterial cell. Next, it form a crystal violet iodine magnesium ribonucleate complex. It means there is formation of complex, that is crystal violet iodine magnesium ribonucleate complex in gram positive bacteria. And such complex is not formed in gram negative bacteria. Why this complex is not formed in gram negative bacteria? Yes, as I said earlier, difference, that is the magnesium ribonucleate is absent in gram negative bacteria. Only this complex, it means the crystal violet iodine magnesium ribonucleate complex is formed in only, it form in only the gram positive bacteria, and this complex is not form in gram negative bacteria because, yes, as it shows absence of, or the magnesium ribonucleate is absent in gram negative bacteria. So this is the reason for forming the complex. Next, that is decolorizing agent. In the 95% of ethanol is used as a decolorizing agent, that the lipids are very negligible amount of cellulose gram positive bacteria or almost absent. Yes, what I am saying, the lipids are negligible amount of in cellulose gram positive bacteria, or the almost it is absent. Therefore the shrinkage of cellulose takes place due to the dehydration. Yes, due to the shrinkage of cell wall, it takes place due to the dehydration and decrease the permeability. In case of gram-negative bacterial cell wall, the lipids are present in abundant quantity. In case of gram-negative bacteria, the lipids are present in larger quantity. Therefore, when the gram-negative bacterial cell is treated with alcohol, when the gram negative bacterial cell is treated with alcohol, it extract the lipids from its cell wall, and cell wall become porous, and the staining agent are washed out through this porous cell wall of gram negative bacteria, and it become colorless. Next, that is counter stain. That is, safranin is used as a counter stain. The gram negative cells are decolorized, so it will absorb the counter stain. And it shows a pink colored cell. In the gram positive cell wall, it retains the stain of primary stain and it shows the presence of violet color. So this is the basic difference between the gram positive and the gram negative bacteria. Next, we will see the procedure. That first, take a clean grease-free slide. Next, prepare a bacterial smear of each microorganism. There are three microorganisms which we are used in practical, that is E. coli, then Bacillus cereus, and third, that is Staphylococcus aureus. Then fix the smear by the method of heat fixation. Then place a slide on the staining tray and float the smear with crystal violet, that is your primary stain. Next, allow the staining solution to react with bacterial cell for 30 to 60 seconds. Then wash the smear with water. Then wash the smear with water and few drop of grams iodine solution and keep it for a 1 minute. Grams iodine solution, it is a mordant. Next, wash the slide carefully with 95% of alcohol, that is your decolorizing agent. and washing the solution till washing the solution become violet color. Then again wash the slide with water and add a few drop of counter stain, that is safranin, and allow to react for a few seconds. Next, again wash the slide, yes, then wash the slide and dry it, that is natural drying. Keep in mind here there is no use of artificial drying, only the natural drying. Then add one drop of cedar oil and observe under oil immersion objective, that is 100x objective. So this is all about the procedure. Next we will see the observation and result. The smear prepared on the glass slide first, that is A slide, it shows pink color rod shaped bacteria, that is gram negative bacilli. Then smear prepared with second on slide B, that is slide B, it means the slide A, it means Escherichia coli. Then slide B, it means Bacillus cereus, and slide C, that is Staphylococcus aureus. The label the slide during procedure, the slide A, slide B, and slide C. Slide A is, it means the Escherichia coli, and slide B, Bacillus cereus, and third slide C, that is Staphylococcus aureus. Yes, observational result. The smear is prepared on slide A. It shows pink color rod shaped bacteria, that is gram negative bacilli. Then next, the smear prepared on slide B shows violet color rod shaped bacteria, that is gram positive bacilli. Then smear prepared on glass slide C, it shows deep violet colored spherical shaped bacteria, that is gram positive staphylococci. So this is all about this observation and result. Next we will see the questions based on this practical. First question, the fixation of smear is carried out by which method, or which method is used for fixation of smear, that is heating. Answer for this, the heating method is used for fixation of smear. Next question, in which bacterial cell magnesium ribonucleate is present? Yes, magnesium ribonucleate is present in only gram positive bacteria. Then third question, what is the major component of cell wall of bacteria? Yes, peptidoglycan is the major component of cell wall of bacteria. Next, who discovered the gram staining technique? Yes, name of the scientist, that is Christian Gram. Then what is the use of alcohol in gram staining? Yes, 95% alcohol is used as for the purpose of, that is decolorizing agent. Next question, in gram staining which stain is used as a primary stain? That is by the use of crystal violet, that is the crystal violet is used as a primary stain. So this is all about the gram staining technique, or the to study the bacterial morphology by the use of gram staining technique. Yes, this is all about this practical. Next practical we will see in next